Now, what do you suppose is going to happen when we have a volume of charge? If we have a volume of charge, let's draw our x and our y. Z would come out this way. Excuse me. And let's have a little bit of cube right here that has a charge in it. So the charge right here is going to be a volume charge distribution, which is going to be 3 amps per meter cubed, and it's going to go to the x equal 1, y equal 1, z equal 1 corners. The first thing that we do is we write Rs. Rs is the vector from the origin to a point on my source, my current density. Oh, and I need to give a direction to my current density. Let's let that be going in the z direction. So Rs is equal to xs in the x direction plus ys in the y direction plus zs in the z direction. None of these are constant, so I can't make any changes or simplifications at this point. Let's find where we want to find the magnetic field. Let's suppose that I want to find H right here out on the x-axis at the point where x is 4, y is 0, and z is 0. So Rp is going to be xp in the x direction plus yp in the y direction plus zp in the z direction. But xp is 4, yp is 0, and zp is 0, so I can simplify this one. Then Rsp is Rp minus Rs, which is going to give me 4 minus xs in the x direction minus ys in the y direction minus zs in the z direction. Let's define our current. I, in this case, is going to be jv dv. So that is going to be 3, and then what's dv? dv is a small piece of this volume, so it's going to be dx, dy, and dz, and since I know I'm going to be integrating the source, those are the s terms. Now I need a direction here, and that is the direction of the current, z. Now let's do our I cross R term. And let's draw our 3x3 matrix. Here's x, here's minus y, and here's z. Plug in I on this row, and plug in R on this row. So I has only a z term now. It is 3 dxs, dys, dzs, and 0 every place else. The R vector, that's right here, is going to be 4 minus xs minus ys and minus zs. Now let's do our cross product. Take out the column and the row that x is in, and cross multiply, right here is 0, minus this value, which is going to give me plus ys times 3 dxs, dys, dzs, and that's going to be in the x direction. The y part is going to be, again, cross multiplying, is going to be this minus that. 3 dxs dys dzs times 4 minus xs. Those minuses cancel out. Now let's consider the z term. The z term, again, eliminate column and row, cross multiply, that's 0, and this is 0. So the answer that I get there is 0. Now let's take I and take a good look at what we've got here. In all cases, we've got a vector x, here's the vector y, we've got our volume components right there. Bring those to the outside for our convenience, and now we're going to apply Coulomb's law. Sorry, not Coulomb's law, Beelzebub.